The Sahaba, they purified the people after them. And continuously until now, you will see, when we have the awliya, Allah, the murshid. Nowadays, people have a problem in this world. You will see that the people who we consider as murshids, they have a chain going back to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the biggest proof that they are on the haq. Why? They have a chain going back to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this dua was made by who? Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ana da'watu Abi Ibrahim." I am the acceptance of the dua that my father Ibrahim alayhi salam made. The reason he calls him his father is, of course, his Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam is from the lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam through his son Ismail alayhi salam. Wa bushra Isa ibn Maryam, and I am the glad tidings given by Isa alayhi salam. Prophet Isa, he gave the glad tidings as mentioned in Surah As-Saff, and the previous speaker, alhamdulillah, he mentioned it. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, what did he say? وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدُ. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, he says, O Banu Israel, verily I am the messenger of Allah, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ, and I come to verify everything that which is in the Torah, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدُ, and to give you the glad tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name will be Ahmad, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Wa bushra Isa ibn Maryam." I am the glad tidings of Isa alaihi salam. Wa ru'ya ummi allati ra'at hina wada'atni annahu takhruju minha nuran adha'at minhu qusur ash-sham. Aw kama qala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "And I am the dream seen by my mother. When she gave birth to me, she saw that from her emitted a light, and this light illuminated the palaces of Sham. Through this light, she was able, in one narration, it is narrated that Amina alayhi salam, the mother of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, she herself said that when I gave birth to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, I was able to see as far as Sham. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he is talking about himself. He is talking about his life. He is talking about not the life after Nabuwah, but before Nabuwah. Many people, they have a problem with this. They say, especially some people who have something called Siratul Nabi gathering, they say, forget about Miladul Nabi, focus on Siratul Nabi, because the Milad is not important. If it wasn't important, then why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talk about before the Milad, before the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And again, this is a sahih hadith. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke about himself, he spoke about his birth, and he spoke about before he was born sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that is why we speak about the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if it wasn't important, then why would the earliest, when you open a book of seerah, when you open a book of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, till this day, you will not find a single book in which the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not discussed. The birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is discussed. How much time left? You kindly inform me.
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. So you will not find a single book of seerah in which the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not discussed. If it was a bid'ah or impermissible or not recommended to discuss the life, especially the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why did the ulama, why would they discuss it in their books? Why would they discuss the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their books? In fact, Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala, in his Jami' At-Tirmidhi, he has a chapter, Babu ma ja'a fi mawlidin nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning the chapter which discusses whatever concerns the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If it wasn't important to discuss the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why would Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala have an entire chapter dedicated to the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So therefore it is important that we speak about it. So let's go back to the very first text. Did the Sahaba read the Quran? Yes. Did the Sahaba radiallahu anhum discuss the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a gathering? Yes, they did. Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speak about his birth? Yes, he did sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What else do we do in the Milad gathering? We send salat and salam upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now tell me, is this a sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? It is a sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a very famous verse you all know, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Verily Allah and His angels send salat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Now, there are more objections. First of all, why do you do it in a gathering? Why don't you do it privately? You see, in the very verse of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah, verily Allah and His angels. Now tell me, the word angels, is that a singular word or a plural word? It's a plural word. This suggests that they do it together. If you open any book of tafsir, You open any book of tafsir, you will see that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. What is the meaning of yusalluna ala nabi? The vast majority of mufassirin, they say that Allah gathers the angels and he speaks about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah gathers the angels. So they do so in a gathering. Now if it was impermissible to do it in a gathering, then somebody should tell Allah that what he's doing is wrong. Na'udhu billahi min dhalik. So when we do, or when we commemorate the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what do we do? We send salat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, recently somebody said this, that, okay, fine, but why do you stand up? Why not sitting down? Why do you stand up? You know, when we pray salah, when we finish tashahud, do we do standing up or sitting down? Sitting down. So we say Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, standing up or sitting down? Sitting down. So his argument is that why, if it was allowed to do it standing up, then in namaz, why do we do it sitting down? So it's proof that we should not stand up, we should do it sitting down. Now of course this is ignorance. First and foremost, tell me, Salatul Janazah, do we stand up or sit down?
Stand up.
In Salatul Janazah, do we do Salat upon the Prophet Islam? After the second takbir, what do we do? We read durud, don't we? Now do we do it, after the second takbir, we'll sit down, read durud, then get back up. Is that what we do? No, we do it standing up. When you go to Ziyaratul, Ziyaratul Qubur, when you go to Qabr Ziyarat, when you say Assalamu Alaikum, Dara Qawmi Mubini, or whatever Dwayne will be, do you say, when you say Assalamu Alaikum, do you say standing up or sitting down? Have you ever seen someone go to the grave and sit down and give salam? So why is there a problem when we give salam to Rasulullah when we stand up? Why is there a problem? So this is ignorance. Now, again, in the khutbah, the khatib, it is a sunnah, according to Hanafi Madhab, that you send salat upon Rasulullah during the khutbah. Do we stand up or sit down? Okay, it is a bid'ah to sit down for the khutbah. It is a sunnah, in fact, according to the Hanafi school, it's wajib that you stand, and it is a sunnah that you sit between the two. So, is it from Islam? Are there any practices in Islam which suggest that you stand up for salat upon Rasulullah? Yes, there is. In fact, the only time you sit down is normal salat. But every other occasion you stand up. For khutbah, you stand up. When you go to the grave, you stand up. When you do janazah, you stand up. Every other situation, you stand up. Only for normal salat, what do? You sit down. So to say that it is against Islamic practices, against Islamic teachings to stand up and give salam is completely wrong. Now, let's go back. Of course, the Prophet prayed janazah, the Sahaba prayed janazah. This is an obvious yes. But what about reading poems? Poems in the praise of Rasulullah standing up. Did that happen in the time of the Sahaba? Again, the answer is yes. Now, Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah ta'ala, in his Fathul Bari, the greatest commentary on Sahih al-Bukhari is Fathul Bari. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he brings a narration that Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu, a companion who took part, a Sahabi who took part in the Battle of Badr, he was the designated poet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would love it when Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu would praise him. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left this world, there was somebody who was criticizing Hassan bin Thabit. And she said, what's wrong with you? Do you not know that this is Hassan bin Thabit who stood on the minbar and praised Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How dare you criticize him? This is Hassan bin Thabit who took part in Badr. So Sayyidina Hassan bin Thabit, he was commanded by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to stand on his minbar, the minbar of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sit down, stand, and to read verses in his praise. And what are the verses? وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَى قَطُّ عَيْنٌ وَأَجْمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. He says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَحْسَنَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَى قَطُّ عَيْنٌ. No eye has ever seen anything more beautiful than you. وَأَجْمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. And no woman has ever given birth to someone more beautiful than you. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ. You have been created free of all faults. كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. It is as though you created exactly as you wanted, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this was done in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now did the Prophet say, Yo Hassan, sit down, it is bid'ah to stand up? He didn't say this. It is the sunnah of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum to stand up. In fact, Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Now in the Arabic language, the word taslima is called maful mutlaq. Maful mutlaq has many meanings, has three meanings. One of them is to show perfection. Meaning when you send salam, you send it perfectly. You send it with the most utmost respect. Now in our tradition, usually, how do we show respect? By standing up. Now, we don't criticize. If somebody wants to sit down, that's fine. When I was in Yemen, there's a masjid called Masjid Ba'alawi. And when they send salam, they used to sit down. They never used to stand up. Why? Just to avoid any difference of opinion. Just to avoid any fitna, just to avoid any problem, they used to sit down. That's fine. But there is nothing wrong with standing up. In fact, it is a proven practice from the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. And inshallah, by saying some conclude, before I conclude, let's go back to that checklist. Did the Sahaba celebrate the Mawlid? What was the Mawlid? To read the Quran, to discuss the aspects of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to send salat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did the Sahaba do this? Yes. Did the Tabi'in do this? Yes. Did the four Imams do this? Of course they did. Every single Muslim has been doing it since the very beginning. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open up our hearts to the truth. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a true understanding of this beautiful religion. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite us upon the love of His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. I apologize if I've caused offense. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all.